There's a budget deficit and significant changes to social issues on the table.
11 News reporter David Collins is sorting it all out. He's live at the State House with more. David?
Well, opening day is always filled with hope, and a freshman delegate from Baltimore City is hoping to make his mark early.
Newly elected Baltimore City delegate Kiefer Mitchell, with his family in tow, successfully navigated through a throng of special interest groups to find his seat in the House chamber.
Another Mitchell on the board.
The freshman's very first bill is legislation to legally recognize same-sex marriage in Maryland.
The time is now. If Maryland was founded on tolerance, we got to continue that tradition.
There is already bipartisan support for civil unions.
I just thought that this year was the right year to do it. I think there's a good opportunity to find, to have some legislation passed that would provide equal rights to same-sex as well as opposite-sex couples.
And bear true allegiance to the state of Maryland.
Opening day is traditionally a pomp and circumstance affair. The House has 30 new members. The sound of crying babies competed with the mass swearing-in ceremony. Rookie instructions sounded funny. Please push the green button to record your presence. Members re-elected Michael Bush as Speaker.
Could I have the 10 new senators stand, please?
Civility ruled in the Senate, too. The upper chamber has 10 new members. Senators re-elected Mike Miller as President. They praised his ability to supervise 46 super egos. They refer to the longest-serving president in the U.S. as their permanent leader. Governor O'Malley addressed both chambers.
We have tough choices to make, and we're going to make them together.
The governor, who's keeping budget cut details to himself, says he will keep an open mind on tax hikes the General Assembly may come up with. An increase in alcohol and the gasoline tax are on the table. The governor wants to start peeling back on furlough days. AFSCME union members don't like what they hear about the governor's pension reform plans.
Enough is enough.
They rallied, then began an intense lobbying effort to preserve and fully fund the status quo.
We're dedicated on public service for the state of Maryland, and we're no different. Everything is always taken off our backs.
The governor's legislative agenda includes harnessing wind power. A sea of supporters wearing light blue T-shirts also started an intense lobbying campaign.
Utilities don't like to be locked into long-term contracts. They basically don't like to be told what to do. We're saying that the state should tell the utilities they need to buy the power from offshore wind.
New state Senator Victor Ramirez of Prince George's wants to give illegal aliens who complete school in Maryland an in-state tuition break on college. Baltimore County Delegate Patrick McDonough opposes. He is targeting illegal immigration with 16 bills.
All of my bills, my whole program is about money and jobs. It's not about emotion. It's not about who is a racist. It's not about who doesn't like foreigners. That's all pathetic rhetoric by the left.
Much of the real work begins next week. That's also when the governor officially submits his budget proposal to the General Assembly. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.